Hi, Chris here with the MarsTech Balcony Solar Storage System. This is called this model the B2500, and it does have a capacity of 2.24 kilowatt hours, but you can expand upon it right up to 6.72 kilowatt hours. Now, it is using LFP battery cells, so one of the best, and they are good for 6,000 cycles, around about 10 years, and then the capacity will drop down to about 80%, so very good. It's really easy to connect up. It only takes about 15 minutes, and I'll be running through that in this video. So you basically connect it up to your solar panels, your own microinverter, and then you plug the microinverter into your home grid, and it's going to be then giving you those savings. You can reap the rewards of having your own solar panels and this battery backup too. Now you can get it to bypass, so you can put the power just straight into your home grid, or have it store first in this battery, and that will give you then some runtime for the night. For example, you've got 800 watts output of this, and then the solar input is up to 1,000 watts. And yes, it is IP65 waterproof, so you can have this out in the rain, in the sun. It's not really going to be too much of an issue. So this is what we do get with the B2500 from MarsTech. We have four cables here. They're using the MC4 connector. So we need these in order to connect up to our battery station here, the battery bank, and then our microinverter. Now they do also include a plastic tool here that is for those MC4 connectors. Now it is a very flexible battery solar storage system, because all you need to really have this up and running is your own microinverter. Now it's gonna work with 99% of the microinverters out there. Now this one is 800 watts is what you want, because that's the maximum output. So you have your solar panels, your microinverter, and I'll show you how it all works. So I'll be connecting this up now, but our input is into the B2500, and that goes then into the microinverter, and the microinverter through the AC out is then going to be putting that power back into our grid. I have here the single MarsTech B2500. Now the build quality is very good. We have a nice industrial looking design to it. Now this is waterproof. It's IP65, so no problems if it gets rained on, a little bit of weather. Now, ideally, you don't want to have it in the sun the whole time, because it could possibly overheat. Now, there's built-in safety here with those LFP batteries, and you don't really have to worry about that, because they've got a 7-tier system that's going to be checking all of that with the battery monitoring system. So if it was to overheat, it would shut itself down. So it's all going to be safe. And of course, those cells, as I said there at the start, they're good for 6,000 cycles, 10 years, and even after those 6,000 cycles, it just drops down to 80%. So here on the front, we do have some status LEDs, our main button here, so turning it on or hold this down to turn it off. And we have both Bluetooth connectivity and wireless 2.4 gigahertz. So the top portion is where you will find our solar inputs here. Now this is 1,000 watts max. There are two different circuits, so 500 watts each, and I'm only using one of them in this video for demonstration purposes, because I don't have another free panel, otherwise I'd have two connected up to this. So this is where our 1,000 watts input is, and then the bottom area output from these four connectors here is 800 watts max. So this is where we're going to be plugging in those four included cables to then connect up to our microinverter. So this storage system is expandable too. We have this rubber gasket here. This is waterproof to cover over the expansion port. And this is where you can take the capacity of it from a single unit, 2.24 kilowatt hours, right up to 6.72 kilowatt hours, depending on your needs. So that is two units per battery you can plug into it. Now they do say the installation takes about 15 minutes, and I can believe that, because it is very easy to set up. You just need to plug in those cables to your microinverter, and this is all straightforward. They simply just pop in like so. And this microinverter is also waterproof. They normally all are. And again, you don't want to have this in the sun. It's only for demonstration purposes that I have everything like this all out in the open. So there it is. It is really as simple as that. So I have my solar panels here, and I could have two, as I mentioned before. Then we have our B2500 balcony solar storage system, my microinverter, everything's all hooked up. And this plug, this is going out to the grid. And say this is on your balcony, or you have it outside, maybe in your garden or just outside of your garage or something, you have that plugged into the wall socket. So that's going to be putting, at peak, 800 watts into the grid that I can use for my home appliances, all from the energy that I've been generated, the power that I've generated from this solar panel, and then it's being stored, of course, in this battery bank here. So it's a very simple, easy system to set up. Let's have a look at the application now and how we can control just how much power we are going to save. We can bypass it as well, and other options we do get with our MarsTech B2500. Here is our application. It's called MarsTech, and when you get into it, the first screen has all that information clearly labeled here, what is currently happening, so you can see the process. Now, I'm just using a virtual setup here, so this is just a simulation of what it looks like, because I'm not within coverage range of it to connect up to my wireless or the Bluetooth, but this gives you an idea of all you need to know with the application. So you can see the wattage going into the battery here, the discharge if you're discharging. Now, I've got a screen capture here when I was discharging and using that battery to output the wattage into my house. You can see that just going up and down there. So it was definitely using the battery. The inverter was getting a little bit warm, and my battery percentage, you can see, was dropping down a little bit there. So we have options for the charging settings. So you can get it to fully charge the battery first, those LFP cells, and then discharge. So that's going to be great for nighttime use, or have it just pass through. So you can have the both of the solar inputs, the PV1 and 2, just go straight into your microinverter, then straight into your house to top up and give you that power straight away throughout the day. It depends on how you want to have that set up. And then jumping into these settings, so at the top there, I've just blurred my email address. That's the only thing, the reason I blurred that out. You can share the device, so you can pass it on to someone else, give them access to it. Wi-Fi configuration, your depth of discharge value, so that's from 100 to 0. And then we have this here, which is our discharge threshold. So when it drops below this, it'll then be outputting that power from the batteries into your grid. So you can set this anywhere from 0 to 500 watts. You can put it to, say, 50. So when your panels drop below 50, then the battery is going to kick in and start outputting there. So that's the settings we have. And then we've got stats here. For example, our power and all of our statistics there too will be available once you're running that for some time. And there is a firmware update or updates that are pushed through for the B2500 and our app version there. So it's a good app. And what I like is when you get straight into it, you have all of that information you want on first glance, and it's all from the same screen right here. All right, it's night now, and our current usage is around about 490 to 480 watts. What I'm going to do now is turn on our MarsTech B2500, and it's going to be then putting power into the grid, and we'll see what the result is. So I've just used the app to turn on the discharge now. So the battery is feeding into the microinverter, then the microinverter is now feeding that power into the grid. Let's go back to that smart meter and see if there's any difference. All right, it's a little hard to see here, but it is now showing negative 0.26. So that means I'm putting back into the grid 260 watts. So it's definitely making a big difference there. In fact, all the appliances that are currently on, it's covering them all with about the 800 watts that it is sending out to the house. All right, so that is the MarsTech B2500. I love how simple this is, the simplicity of it, that you simply plug in your solar panels into the PV input. You have the PV output then from our battery station here that goes into your microinverter. The microinverter then goes into the grid, of course, and then you get those savings on your power bill. Now, depending on your own needs, you can get up to three of these, as I pointed out, with a maximum capacity then with the three units of 6.72 kilowatt hours. And that will last most people, I think, throughout the night, depending, of course, on what you are running. Remember, the maximum output is 800 watts, and that's going to be helping out with your power bill just to lessen it off, but it won't be able to cover demanding things like home appliances like your oven, your stove tops, electric ones, things like that, which will use a little bit more, but it still will make a difference in your power bill to help reduce it there. And the longevity of this unit here is great because it does have a guarantee, they say, with 10 years with the batteries within this, which are the LPF batteries. So 6,000 cycles around about 10 years, the capacity is going to drop down then to 80%, which is still excellent and very good there. And with the app, as I showed you, you can bypass it and have it putting the PV output, so your solar wattage, your output there, to go straight into your microinverter, straight into your home, or firstly charge up our balcony solar storage system here first, and then at nighttime you can have it then deliver that power into your home grid. So thank you so much for watching this hands-on and my first impressions here of the MarsTech B2500.